Good morning, students. Today we shall be discussing a new topic from the chapter waves. In our previous classes, we had studied the different topics from the same chapter. The last thing that was discussed was superposition of waves, in which we had studied up till periodic wave functions, periodic wave, harmonic wave functions and harmonic waves. So today we shall discuss the topic of progressive waves, or what are called traveling waves. Let's begin with the basic definition for a progressive wave. What is a progressive wave? A wave which travels continuously in a medium in the same direction without any change in its amplitude is called a progressive wave or a traveling wave. A progressive wave may be transverse or longitudinal in nature. Now you already know what is a transverse wave and what are longitudinal waves. Transverse waves are those in which particles of the medium vibrate up and down at right angles to the direction of wave propagation, whereas longitudinal waves are those in which particles of the medium vibrate back and forth in the direction of wave propagation. Right now on your screen, you can see the graph for a progressive wave traveling along positive x-axis. Suppose that a plain simple harmonic wave travels from the origin O along the positive x direction of x-axis. Now this is the displacement curve of the wave at any time t. Now if time is counted from the instant the particle at the origin just passes through mean position in positive direction, then the displacement of a particle at O and at any time t, is given by y equal to r sine omega t, where r is the amplitude of the simple harmonic motion executed by the particle and omega is its angular frequency. Now let us find the displacement of the particle at point P, situated at a distance x from the origin at any time t. A particle on the positive x-axis receives disturbance at a definite time later than that preceding it. Therefore, the phase lag of the particles with respect to the particle at the point O goes on increasing as we move more and more away from the point O. Let's go back to the graph to understand it a bit more clearly. I was saying that the phase lag of the particles with respect to the particle at the point O goes on increasing as we move more and more away from this particular point. So if phi is the phase lag of the particle at point P with respect to that at point O, then the displacement of the particle at point P at any time t is given by y equal to r sine omega t minus phi. Now since for a distance lambda, phase changes by 2 pi. So the change in phase for a distance x will be given by 2 pi by lambda into x. So thus phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into x. Now if we put this value of phi in this equation, then we shall get y equal to r sine omega t minus, in place of phi we write down 2 pi by lambda into x. So if t is the period of vibration, then omega is equal to 2 pi by t. So again, we get y equal to r sine, in place of omega, we write down 2 pi by t. So 2 pi by t into t minus 2 pi by lambda into x. So taking out 2 pi as common, we get y equal to r sine 2 pi t by t minus x by lambda. Let us mark it as equation number 4. So the equation, that is equation number 4, is the equation of a plane progressive simple harmonic wave traveling along the positive x-axis. Now we know that for a wave motion v, that is the wave velocity, is equal to nu into lambda. Nu is a frequency, lambda is a wavelength. So nu will be v by lambda. Now frequency is 1 upon time period, so we can write down 1 by t equal to v by lambda. So thus this equation in a modified form becomes y equal to r sine 2 pi v by lambda into t minus x by lambda, in place of t we have written v by lambda into t minus x by lambda. So taking out lambda is common, so this equation becomes y equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. So now equation 4 can be further written as this. Now this is the equation for a plane progressive simple harmonic wave traveling along positive x axis. Now for a progressive wave traveling along negative x axis, if the wave is traveling along negative x axis, then we can write down the equations in this manner: y equal to r sine t by t, so now y will be equal to r sine 2 pi t by t plus x by lambda, and y will be equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt plus x. So you can compare these two equations with the previous ones. Like, just see this equation for a wave traveling along positive x-axis. So r sine 2 pi t by t minus x by lambda, and this equation is r sine 2 pi t by t plus x by lambda. So there is just the difference. Similarly, compare equation number 5 with this one. So again, the positive sign. This is the basic difference between the two waves, one along the positive x-axis and one traveling along the negative x-axis. Now, this particular equation actually gives the displacement at any position x and at any time t. Now, at any position, for a fixed value of x, the displacement again becomes the same after a certain time. What should be that time? The time should be equal to the time period. So after a time equal to the time period of the wave, the displacement again becomes the same. So if we substitute t plus t, this capital T is the time period in place of t in the general equation for a plane progressive wave. So y is equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda v, and in place of t, what we have written, t plus t minus x. Let's expand it. So r sine 2 pi by lambda v t, and putting this minus x over here, plus vt. So now r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, and we have put this 2 pi by lambda inside, so 2 pi by lambda into lambda, substituting for this expression. So obviously this becomes y equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x plus 2 pi, And hence, we come back to the previous equation y equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. It tells that the time period of a vibrating particle is capital T. Similarly, at any time for t fixed, the displacement again becomes the same at a distance equal to lambda. So if we substitute x plus lambda instead of x, we will once again get this very equation. Let's solve one question. The equation of a plane progressive wave is given by this equation y equal to 10 sine 2 pi t minus 0.005 x. Is the equation of a plane progressive wave, where y and x are in centimeter and t is in seconds. So what are we supposed to calculate? Calculate the amplitude, frequency, wavelength and velocity of the wave. So let's first of all identify the values from the given equation. That is what the equation asks us to do. So writing down the equation, y is equal to 10 sine 2 pi t minus 0.005 x. So this becomes 10 sine 2 pi into 0.005, taking out 0.005 as common. So this becomes t by 0.005 minus x. We have to write down this equation in the basic form. That is the general equation of a plane progressive wave in that form. So this becomes y equal to 10 sine 2 pi by 200. So 0.005, you may write it down as 5 by 1000 and cancel it out. So that becomes 1 by 200. So 10 sine 2 pi by 200 in brackets. Similarly, you may write it down as 200 t minus x. So since y is equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, now straight away you may compare the terms. So in place of r, 10 is there, sine 2 pi by lambda, so lambda is 200, v is 200 minus x. So on straight comparison, you get r equal to 10 centimeter, lambda equal to 200 centimeter and v equal to 200 centimeter per second. Simply by comparing. So nu is equal to v by lambda. So v is 200, lambda is 200, so you get 1 hertz. So frequency is 1 hertz. So very basic question based on simple identification from the general equation of a plane progressive wave. Now let's understand some basic terms related to a wave. Wave velocity, particle acceleration, phase and phase difference, beginning with wave velocity. It is the velocity with which a progressive wave travels through the medium. So it is a constant quantity and it is given by v equal to nu lambda, when nu is the frequency and lambda is the wavelength of the waves. Particle velocity. A wave propagates through a medium due to repeated periodic motion of the particles of the medium. So obviously, the velocity of a particle will continuously change with time. The instantaneous particle velocity of a particle is defined as the time rate of change of its displacement at that time. It is denoted by U, small alphabet U. So the displacement of a particle in a progressive wave at any time, we know it's given by y equal to r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. So the instantaneous particle velocity, that is u, will be given by d by dt of y. So we need to differentiate this expression with respect to time. So substituting the expression for y, r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, we need to differentiate it with respect to time. So r is constant, taking it out. Sine of any term is cos. So this becomes cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. And then we need to differentiate this particular term. So this becomes 2 pi by lambda v. So So on further solving, we get u to be equal to 2 pi rv by lambda cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Now 2 pi rv by lambda can be written as, taking out r as common, 2 pi v by lambda, and v by lambda is nu, so we may write down r into 2 pi nu. So this becomes u equal to r omega, 2 pi nu is omega, so r omega cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. So the maximum particle velocity, maximum value will be obtained when this value becomes equal to 1. So obviously then u max will be equal to r omega, and this is known as velocity amplitude. Now switching over to the next term, that is particle acceleration. The instantaneous particle acceleration is given by f equal to d by dt of u. We need to differentiate the expression for particle velocity with respect to time. So in a similar manner, once we proceed with the differentiation d by dt and then substituting the expression for u that we obtained in the previous case, u is equal to r omega cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. So we need to substitute this and then differentiate it with respect to time. So we obtain this particular expression, f equal to minus r omega square sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. And if you can see, sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, this particular r sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x is nothing but equal to y, that is the displacement of a plane progressive wave. So now we may write down f to be equal to minus omega square y. The maximum particle acceleration obviously will be obtained when this entire term of sine becomes equal to 1. So f max will be equal to minus r omega square. So this is known as acceleration amplitude. Phase. The argument of sine in the equation of the progressive wave, phi is 2 pi t by t minus x by lambda. So this is nothing but phase of the wave. It follows that the phase of the wave is function of both t and x. That is, it varies both with the time and the position. Now what is phase change with time? Delta phi is equal to 2 pi by t into delta t. At a given point, for x constant, the phase changes with time t. The phase change at a given point in time delta t is given by delta phi equal to 2 pi by t into delta t. Similarly, phase change with position. At a given time, for t equal to constant, the phase changes with position x. So the phase change at a given time for a change in position delta x is given by delta phi equal to minus 2 pi by lambda into delta x. The negative sign indicates that for a progressive wave traveling along positive x-axis, the farther away a particle is situated from the origin, the more it lags behind in phase. In other words, such a point attains the corresponding stage of oscillation later. This would be all for today's class. We shall be discussing more from this lesson in the coming video lessons, and we shall be studying about characteristics of progressive wave motion and standing waves. Thank you.